Did you know you can make a logo in Microsoft PowerPoint? Starting in PowerPoint, click on the Design tab, then choose Slide Size. Change the size to 8.5 by 11 so we can print it. On the top panel, choose Insert, then select Word Art. There are so many fun things you can do with Word Art. Right now, I'm just putting my name and that I'm a teacher. On the top panel, choose Shape Format, then the small blue A and click on Transform. This will take our regular text to a curve. You can play around with this till you get it just right. You can even add more text if you want a bigger circle. You can change the font and the color if you'd like also. There's so many ways you could use this word art, and I love that you can change the size and make the circles bigger. We can add our initials inside the logo. This is done by inserting a text box and then choosing a font, changing the font size to fit inside. This logo is going to go on top of the class crest, which is a really fun get-to-know-you activity. Holding Shift and selecting the text box and the word art, we can right-click and group these together. Back at the panel, we're in Insert and choosing this shape. This is going to become the class crest. Once you're in Shape Format, you can quickly change the color of the shape and you can change the width of the outline. Going back into Shapes, we're inserting a line. This crest is really fun to do with your students or your own children. So here we can change the width of the line. I like to keep everything matching, so setting this at 3. Don't forget you can change the color of the line to whatever you want. These are going to be printed for a classroom, so that's why we're keeping it black and white. Once you have your first line how you want it, you just repeat that process and you'll see it starts to look like a crest. And now we're ready to add our logo right to the center. Let's go back to Shapes and insert a circle. Change the fill to white and no outline. We want to be able to see the logo but not the lines on the crest. Once everything is formatted right, we're going to right click on the circle we just created and we're going to choose Send Backwards. Now we'll be able to see our logo clearly without the lines intersecting. This is a great way to get to know your students. They could use images or words in the spaces to show you what their values are, what their interests, what their goals are. They can color it, cut it out, and then it looks great up on a bulletin board. We have our text boxes how we want them, so we can do one last step. Pressing Command D on that shape, we just duplicate it and make it a little bit larger. That's gonna give it a really nice outline. Just making that shape black and sending it to the back. Now we have a class crest and a logo using PowerPoint.